Hello everyone, I am Dr. Dharminder Singh from Department of Mechanical Engineering, Government Engineering College, Bikaner, is going to discuss today about powder metallurgy. So, we can define powder metallurgy is the name given to the process by which fine powder materials are blended, pressed into a desired shape, and then heated to the bonded surfaces. It is an art and science of producing metals or metallic powders and using them to make finished or semi-finished products. Alternatively, it may also be defined as material processing technique used to consolidate matter, that is powders, both metals and or non-metals. This technology is probably the oldest forming technology known to man. Now question is, in spite of having so many manufacturing technologies, why we are going for powder processing? So the parts produced by powder metallurgy have adequate physical and mechanical properties while completely meeting the functional performance characteristics. The cost of producing a component of a given shape and the required dimension tolerances by the powder metallurgy is generally lower than the cost of casting or making it as a wrought product because of extremely low scrap and fewer processing steps. It is also used in the case where it is difficult to produce alloys by melting the different constituting components of the alloy. Parts can be produced which are integrated with oil or plastic or inflated with lower melting point metal. They can be electroplated, heat treated, and machined if necessary. The rate of production of parts is quite high and few hundreds to several thousands per hour. Typically used when large amount of small intricate parts with higher precision are required. Used for parts in automotive industry, household appliances, and recreational equipments. An important point that comes out here is that the entire material need not be melted to fuse it. The working temperature is well below the melting point of the major constituent, making it a very suitable method to work with refractory materials as mentioned. Actually, powder metallurgy is having the basic steps as powder production, blending or mixing of the powders, powder compaction, sintering, and finishing operations if required. Here in the figure, it is shown that the powder in the raw form and later it is formed as a product, and finally it comes out as a sintered product. Here the simplified flow chart of the basic powder metallurgy process is shown. When we talk about the powders, we have to talk about the powder fabrication, size and shape characterization, the microstructure of the powder and its chemical homogeneity, then processing. During processing, we have to take care of compaction, sintering, maybe forging or hot processing. Properties means density, porosity, ductility, strength, conductivity and other functional properties of the product. This flow chart shows the complete powder metallurgy process, starting from powder manufacturing to the sintered product and secondary finishing operations. So the first basic is the production of metallic powders. The selection of materials in powder metallurgy is determined by two factors, that is the alloy required in the finished part, and second, physical characteristics needed in the powder. The properties of the powder metallurgy products are highly dependent on the starting powder. Both of these factors are influenced by process used for making powder. The choice of a specific technique for powder production depends upon particle size, shape, microstructure and chemistry of the powder, and also on the cost of process. In general, producers of metallic powders are not the same companies as those that are making the powder metallurgy parts. Any metal can be made into powder form. The three principal methods by which metallic powders are commercially produced are physical methods, mechanical methods and chemical methods of powder production. In addition, mechanical methods are occasionally used to reduce powder. The first method of powder production is the automation process. The automation process is basically of three types: water automation, gas automation and special automation method. This uses high pressure fluid jet to break up a molten metal stream into very fine droplets, which then solidify into fine particles. The majority of commercial powders are produced by automation technique. The molten metal is forced through an orifice into a stream of high velocity air, steam or inert gas. This causes extremely rapid cooling and disintegration into very fine powder. The use of this process is usually limited to metals with low melting point. The figure here shows A and B are gas atomization methods. C is a water atomization method and D is a centrifugal atomization by the rotating disk method. Some other mechanical methods of powder production are chopping or cutting, aberration methods, machining methods, milling, and cold stream process. The chemical methods of powder production are reduction of oxides, precipitation from solutions, thermal decomposition of compounds, hydride decomposition, thermit reaction, and electrochemical methods. Now, after the production of powder, the particle size or the shape in the metal powders may be, as mentioned here, acicular, irregular, flake type, dendritic, spherical, irregular, rounded particles, porous, and angular. The particle shape is the most important characteristic that defines the quality of the part manufactured. Some characteristics of powders are surface area, density, the flow rate, grain strength of the powder, grain spring, compressibility or compression ratio, particle shape that depends upon, as already I have discussed, on powder production method, the particle size, it means diameter of spherical particles, or it is an average diameter in case of non-spherical particles. The particle size distribution is defined as shape factor and the aspect ratio. After production of powders, the second step in the powder metallurgy technique is the blending and mixing of the metallic powders. So, for getting the successful results in compaction and sintering, the starting powder must be homogenized. It means the powder should be blended and mixed thoroughly. Blending a coarser fraction with the finer fraction ensures that the interstices between large particles will be filled out. As we can see in the figure, the metallic powder of different shapes and sizes have to be mixed thoroughly for getting better sintered products. Blending means powders of different metals and other materials may be mixed in order to impart special physical and mechanical properties throughout mechanical alloying. Lubricants may be mixed to improve the powder's flow characteristics. Binders such as wax or thermoplastic polymers may be added to improve the grain strength of the product. Blending can also be defined as powders of same chemistries but possibly different particle sizes are intermingled. Means different particle sizes are often blended to reduce the porosity. Powder metallurgy technology allows mixing of various metals into alloys that would be difficult or impossible to produce by other means. Mixing means powders of different chemistries are combined. We can see here, to make a homogeneous mass with uniform distribution of particle size and composition, powders made by different processes have different sizes and shapes. Mixing of powders of different metals and materials. The mixing is generally carried out in air or inert gases to avoid the oxidation. Liquids for better mixing, elimination of dust and reduced explosion hazards. Additives that are added during blending are lubricants, binders, deflocculants. The purpose of blending is uniform distribution of powder. The important is here that problems faced during blending and mixing are variation in the particle size distribution, oxidation of powder and segregation of powder. So this has to be taken care during mixing and blending. The various types of mixing methods are convective mixing, means transfer of one group of particles from one location to another. Diffusive mixing means movement of particles on to newly formed surface. Third, shear mixing means deformation and formation of planes within the powders. Depending on the extent of mixing, mixing can be classified as perfectly mixed or uniform mixing, random mixing, and totally unmixed. The mixing should be stopped when random mixture is achieved. Overmixing leads to reduced flow characteristics of the mixture. Now, some common equipments used for blending powders are cylindrical, rotational, double cone, and twin shell type. A mixer suitable for blending of mixing of metal powders is shown here in the figure. Next is the compaction. Compaction is an important step in powder processing as it enables the forming of loose metal powders into required shapes with sufficient strength to withstand till sintering is completed. Loose powders are compacted and densified into a shape known as green compact. In general, compacting is done without the application of heat. Loose powders are converted into required shape with sufficient strength so that it may withstand ejection from the tools and subsequent sintering processes. In case of cemented carbide, hot compaction is made followed by sintering. Now, the compacting is generally done with mechanical presses and rigid tools. Hydraulic and pneumatic presses can be used. Conventional compacting means simply pressing. Here, as shown in the figure, the opposing punches squeezes the powder contained in a die. The work part after pressing is called a green compact. The word green means not yet fully processed. But the green strength of the part when pressed is adequate or sufficient for handling, but it is far less than that achieved after sintering. Compacting is carried out by pouring a measured amount of metal powder into the dew cavity and then compacting the metal powder into a coherent mass by means of two or more plungers. Pressing or compacting may be achieved from both top and bottom of the top and bottom, and the compact is better than compressing from top only, because the pressure distribution and porosity distribution are more uniform when compressed from both top and bottom. To improve the uniformity of pressure and porosity throughout the piece, the use of the lubricants such as graphite may be made. The bond strength between the particles is affected by the area of contact and by cleanliness of the particles. The powders do not flow like liquid. They can simply be compressed. Compacting consolidates and identifies the component for transportation to the sintering furnace. The forces observed here are resistance of the punch and friction between the particle and the die surface. The figure shows the compacting sequence which is usually performed at room temperature adding of metal powders, pressing, ejecting the component after compacting, pushing the compact and recycling. The figure shows the typical presses used for compacting of the metal powders. Now the next is the sintering. In sintering operation, the pressed powder compacts obtained after compacting are heated in a controlled atmosphere to right below the melting point. The heating facilitates bonding between the individual powder particles and increases the strength of the compact. This is carried out in a controlled, inert or reducing atmosphere or in a vacuum to prevent the oxidation. It is mentioned by researchers that the primary driving force for sintering is the reduction of surface energy. The part shrinkage occurs during sintering due to the pore size reduction. During sintering process, three stages of sintering are melting of the minor constituent, diffusion, and third, the mechanical bonding. All the three stages must be conducted so that the oxidation should not took place. The parts obtained after compacting are transformed to much stronger parts. The figure shows the particle bonding is initiated at contact point. The contact points grow into necks. The pores between the particles are reduced in size and the grain boundaries develop between particles in place of necked regions. The sintering may be carried out in batches or continuously. In batch type and continuous furnaces, the shrinkage fills the holes within the compact, increases the area of contact and reduces the size of holes in the compact. The strength, ductility and density of powder metallurgy parts is much lower than that for corresponding cast parts. Most powder metallurgy products are ready to use after sintering process. Some products may use secondary operations to provide enhanced precision, improved properties, or some special characteristics. Also, distortion may occur during non-uniform cool down, so the parts or the products may be repressed, coined or sized to improve the dimensional precision. Powder metallurgy products can also be subjected to conventional finishing operations to ensure close dimensional tolerances, good surface finish, increased density and corrosion resistance. As we also already mentioned that to improve or to provide some special characteristics. So the finishing operations may include repressing, grinding and plating. So first is the coining and sizing. We can define that these are the high pressure compacting operations and their function is to impart greater dimensional accuracy to the sintered parts and greater strength and better surface finish by further densification. Forging. The sintered powder metallurgy parts may be hot or cold forged to obtain exact shape, good surface finish, good dimension tolerance and a uniform and fine grain size. The fourth, powder metallurgical parts are being increasingly used for applications as highly stressed automotive jet engines and turbine components. Next is the impregnation. The inherent porosity of the powder metallurgical parts is utilized by impregnating them with a fluid like oil or grease. A typical application of this operation is for sintered bearing and bushing that are internally lubricated with up to 30% oil by volume by simply immersing them in a heated oil. Such components have a continuous supply of lubricants by capillary action during their use. Infiltration. The pores of the sintered parts are filled with some low melting point metal, with the result that parts hardness and tensile strength are improved. A slug of metal to be impregnated is kept in close contact with the sintered component and together they are heated to the melting point of the slug. The molten metal infiltrates the pores by capillary action. When the process is completed, the component has greater density, hardness and the strength. Here, we have mentioned that the lead has also been used for infiltration of components like bushes, for which lower frictional characteristics are needed. Next is the heat treatment. The sintered powder metallurgical components may be heat treated for obtaining greater hardness or strength in them. This may be achieved through carburizing, nitriding, carbonitriding and tempering. Next is the machining. The sinter components may be machined by processes like turning, milling, drilling, threading, grinding, etc. to obtain various geometrical features in the component. Almost all the commonly used finishing methods are applicable to powder metallurgical parts. Some of them are plating, burnishing, coating, and coloring. We can define plating for improved appearance and resistance to wear and corrosion. The sintered compact may be corrosion free. To avoid penetration, an entrapment of plating solution in the pores of the part and impregnation or infiltration treatment is often necessary before plating copper, zinc, nickel, chromium, and cadmium plating can be applied. Burnishing. To work harden the surface or to improve the surface finish and dimensional accuracy, burnishing may be performed on powder metallurgical components. It is relatively easy to displace metal on powder metallurgical parts than to wrought parts because of surface porosity in the components. The powder metallurgical sintered parts are more susceptible to environmental degradation than cast and machined parts. This is because of interconnected porosity in powder metallurgical components. Here the coating fills in the pores and seals the entire reactive surface and protects the components. Joining. Electrical resistance welding is better suited than oxyacetylene welding and arc welding because of oxidation of the interior porosity. Argon gas welding is suitable for stainless steel powder metallurgical parts. The properties of the powder metallurgical parts obtained depends upon multiple variables like type and size of the powder, amount and type of lubricants, brushing pressure, sintering temperature, sintering time, and finishing treatments. Most important is the mechanical properties that depends upon the density of the sintered product. The basic rules for the design of powder metallurgical parts are: the shape of the part must permit ejection from the die. Powder should not be required to flow into small cavities. The shape of the part should permit the construction of the strong tooling. The thickness of the part should be within the range for which powder metallurgical parts can be adequately compacted. The part should be designed with a few changes in section thickness as possible. Now comes the advantages of powder metallurgical process for structural components. These may be classified into two main headings: cost advantages and advantages due to particular properties of sintered components. Here we have observed that the zero or minimal scrap, avoiding high machining cost in mass production as irregularly shaped holes, flats, counterboards, involute gear teeth, keyways can be molded into the components. Extremely good surface finish at very low additional cost after sizing and coining. Very close tolerances can be achieved without machining operations. Assembly of two or more components or parts can be made in one piece. High production rate can be achieved. Advantages due to particular properties of sintered components. By achieving up to 95% density, the mechanical and physical properties are comparable with cast materials. In certain cases, 99.9% dense structure can be obtained in case of liquid phase sintering. Plating is also possible directly at 90% density and above and after impregnation of the pores at low densities. Damping out vibrations and noise property with controlled residual porosity. Ability to retain lubricants such as lead, graphite and oil, giving less wear and longer life to bearings. Achieving a close control of porosity to give specified balance between strength and lubrication properties. Improved surface finish with close control of mass, volume and density. Components are malleable and can be bent without cracking. So these all are the advantages of powder metallurgical components. Also, the powder metallurgy makes possible the production of hard tools like diamond impregnated tools for cutting porcelain, glass and tungsten carbide. Reactive and non-reactive metals, both having high melting point and low melting point, can be processed by powder metallurgy. There are certain limitations and advantages of powder metallurgy technique is that high tooling cost and equipment cost associated. Metallic powders are expensive. The problems in storing and handling of the metallic powders, the degradation over time, fire hazards in case of certain metals, limitations on part geometry because metal powders do not readily flow in the die during pressing, variations in density throughout part may be a problem. Specifically, in case of complex geometries, as we know that the mechanical properties must be same throughout. Large components cannot be produced on a large scale. Some shapes are difficult to be produced by conventional powder metallurgical routes. So, after all the discussion, It may be concluded that the powder metallurgy technique is gaining popularity these days. Powder metallurgy can create parts that would otherwise be difficult to form. Sintering bonds particles together by allowing atoms to move, forming necks and chain boundaries between the particles. Now, here shows some of the parts fabricated or produced by powder metallurgy. Connecting rod, transmission gears. So, thank you for patience hearing.